Hi students, today our topic is potentiometer. Okay, our topic is potentiometer. So what is the use of potentiometer?
So
potentiometer main purpose is, see here, potentio. So to find out the potential difference between any two points in electrical circuit with accurately, to find out the potential difference between two points in electrical circuit with accurately, you know, voltmeter main purpose is to find out the potential difference. So what is the main difference between voltmeter and potentiometer? Voltmeter shows the reading, but it's not correct. It shows some error. But a potentiometer shows the value with accurately. Next, not only to find out the potential difference between two points, it is also used to measure the unknown EMF of this cell. Okay, for example, one cell is given, you don't know that EMF. Okay, to find out that EMF, useful device is potentiometer with accurately. Next, to compare the EMFs of two cells. Okay, for example, two cells are given. Okay, so to compare the EMFs of these two cells, useful device is potentiometer. Okay, next, to find the internal resistance of the battery or cell. To find out the internal resistance of the battery with accurately, useful device is potentiometer. Okay. Next, to find the thermo-EMF of a thermocouple. Okay. To find the thermo-EMF of a thermocouple. Okay. So main important is these four. Okay. Find out the potential difference between any two points in an electrical circuit. Okay. To measure the unknown EMF of the cell. For example, one cell is given, you don't know that EMF. So how to find out that one? By using a potentiometer. To compare the EMF of the two cells. So two cells are given. Okay. So how to compare that EMFs of the cells? By using a potentiometer. Okay. To find the internal resistance of the battery. Okay. To find the internal resistance of the battery accurately. Okay. To find the thermo-EMF of a thermocouple. Okay. Main uses are these. Okay. Now here, potentiometer is based on one principle. Okay. See here, its principle. Okay. Its principle states that when a constant current is passed through a wire of uniform area of cross section, the potential drop across any portion of the wire is directly proportional to the length of the portion. Okay, once again, it says that when a current is passed through a wire, that wire uniform area of cross section. That wire, uniform area of cross section. That means that is uniform. Okay. The potential drop across any portion of the wire, any portion of the wire is directly proportional to the length of the portion. Directly proportional to the length of the portion. How? How it is directly proportional to the length of the portion? Listen. Consider one wire. Okay. Consider one wire. It is uniformly cross-sectional area. Okay. Now, here, through this one, constant current is passing and its resistance is R. This wire resistance is R. Okay. This wire resistance is R. Now, potential drop, you write as V is equal to formula IR. V is equal to IR. V is equal to I. R is write as rho, length by area. Now here, which one is constant? Current constant. Material is same. Uniform cross-sectional area. Area is also constant. V directly proportional to length. V directly proportional to length. Okay. If in case you draw the graph in between V and length, graph is straight line. Okay. V is equal to, you write as K into L. K is equal to V by L. From this definition, see, from this statement, when a constant current is passed through a wire of uniform area of cross section, the potential drop across any portion of the wire is directly proportional to the length of the portion. See here. Potential drop across, okay, any portion of the wire is directly proportional to the length of the portion. Okay, length of the portion. V directly proportional to L. So, that means here, for example, potential, you apply the potential. This potential is gradually dropped in this wire. Okay, here V, here G means, see, here some potential is dropped, here some potential is dropped, here some potential is dropped. Gradually, that potential is decreased. Gradually, that potential is decreased. That means, for example, here 100 volts applied, okay, in next point 90 volts, in next point 80 volts, in next point 70 volts is dropped, okay, finally the drop is zero. So for example, it is 100 centimeter. So in first to 10 centimeter, it drop is how much? So 100 minus 90, 10 volts. Next centimeter, 10 centimeter. Next 10 centimeter means here also 90 to 80 drop is 10 volts, like that one. Okay. Now here, see, length gradually increases. Potential drop is also gradually increases. Potential drop gradually is also increases. Are understood? See, for here 10 volts per 10 centimeter. Okay. For 20 centimeter means 20 volt per 20 centimeter. Okay. 30 volts per 30 centimeter. Okay. Like that one. Potential is dropped in this wire. Like that one. Potential is dropped in this wire. Okay. Simply that is called as potential per unit length. Simply that is called as potential per unit length. Its name is potential gradient. Are understood? Its name is potential gradient. Now here, potential gradually dropped in this one. Okay. So simply potential drop per unit length is called as potential gradient. It's called as potential gradient. Okay. What is potential gradient? Potential per unit length. Okay. Now here, in this wire, potential is gradually dropped. Okay. For example, you consider 10 centimeter, 10 volts. You consider 20 centimeter, 20 volts. 30 centimeter, 30 volts. 40 centimeter, 40 volts. Like that one, potential is dropped. That potential dropped is nothing but here, potential gradient. Okay. See once again, its principle. It says that when a constant current is passed through the wire of uniform area of cross section, the potential drop across any portion of the wire is directly proportional to the length of the portion. So based on Ohm's law, I'm also derived here, V directly proportional to, that is the statement. Okay, here potential per unit length is nothing but potential gradient, that is represented with here K. Understood? Okay, next, construction of the potentiometer. So generally, potentiometer wire 4 to 10 meters, 4 to 10 meters wire, first of all consider that one, okay, that wire having high resistivity and low temperature coefficient, okay, low temperature coefficient, understood, okay, like manganin and constantin, like manganin and constantin, okay, that wire is completely uniform. Here main condition is wire, that wire is that wire uniform cross sectional area, okay, uniform cross sectional area. So on wooden board, on single wooden board, 4 to 10 meters wire considerably is very difficult, okay, it takes more space, okay, it occupies more space. That's why on wooden board wires arranged like this one, okay, 4 to 10 meters, total 4 to 10 meters, understood, okay. So each one having 100 centimeter, that means each one having 1 meter, okay. If these ends are joined with copper strips, if in case you are joined, these ends are joined with copper strips, now it will be act as a series. It will be act as a series. That means one continuous wire, because of 4 to 10 meters wire, continuous wire taking on wooden board means it is very difficult. Okay, it occupies more space. Okay, this one, these are the potentiometer wires. All wires are having, that means total wire having uniform cross sectional area. Okay, here these are fixed with bolts. It is fixed with bolts. Okay, now this one A, this one is B. Okay, what are these? Are copper strips. These are copper strips. Understood? Okay, now A is connected to the battery. Okay. Here, battery. This one is battery with a key. And one variable resistor, simply rheostat. Okay, rheostat, that means variable resistance. Okay, it is connected to the this one. It is connected to the this one. Understood? Okay. Now here arrange the one skein. Here arrange the 1 meter scale. Here arrange the 1 meter scale. Okay. Now arrange the 1 meter scale. Understood? This terminal connected to the voltmeter, positive and negative, and another point connected to the jockey. Already you know jockey is nothing but one metal rod with a sharp knife edge. Understood? Okay. If in case the jockey is placed here. This voltmeter shows the potential gradient. It shows the potential gradient. Okay. See, simply based on the principle, this battery potential completely dropped in this wire. Here, maximum. Okay. Gradually decreases. And finally, here, zero. That means this potential completely dropped in this wire. Understood? Completely dropped in this wire. Okay. For example, 1 meter means it is 100 centimeter, 200, 300, next 400 centimeter. 400 centimeter. Understood? It is the construction. Construction of the potentiometer. Okay. Potentiometer wire almost 4 to 10 meters. Understood? Okay. Next, theory of a potentiometer. So how to find out the EMF of the cell? Understood? Okay, for our convenient. Once again, I draw potentiometer circuit. This is the wire, total wire AB. Okay. Simply, I consider only in one line. For our convenient only. Okay. Terminal A connected to the battery. Battery MF is E. Okay. One key. It is the rheostat. Okay. Now, here L is the length of the potentiometer wire. Okay. Capital R is resistance of the potentiometer wire. Understood? Capital R is nothing but resistance of the potentiometer wire. Okay. Small r. Here, this is the primary circuit. This one is primary circuit. In this primary circuit, battery is a standard battery. Okay, That is the internal resistance of the standard battery. That means in primary circuit. Next, rheostat resistance is R suffix S. That is series resistance. Okay. It is series resistance. Okay. Now, this resistance is adjusted to the current in primary circuit. Okay. So, this resistance adjusts the current in primary circuit. Understood? Okay. Now, here, total resistance R are in series. R plus series resistance plus internal resistance. R plus R series plus R. R means resistance of the potentiometer wire. R suffix S means series resistance. It is adjustable. This one is adjustable. Small r means internal resistance. In this, current is passing. Okay. It is series. In series, which one is constant? Current is constant. I is equal to total EMF by R plus RS plus R. It is the current. Understood? Now, here L is the length of the wire, R is the resistance of the potentiometer wire. Now here R by L gives the resistance per unit length. Resistance per unit length, it is represented with rho here. It is represented with here rho. Okay, for our convenient only. Okay, if in case you want with x, no problem. Represented with x. Okay, R by L, resistance per unit length. That is represented with rho. Understood? Okay. Now, it is the theory. This one is theory. Okay. Right now, if in case, one unknown EMF cell is given. That cell is connected in secondary circuit. With the help of high resistance box, galvanometer, and jockey. Okay, see, this positive, connected at the terminal point A. Okay, its potential you are taken V. Okay, now the jockey is placed on this one. Okay, placed on this one means it shows the some deflections at certain length. Okay, for example, smaller at certain length. Okay, that length L. Okay, at this length L, galvanometer shows the zero deflection. That means what happened? Why it shows the zero deflection? Once again, battery is connected here. Jockey is drag on this wire. At certain length of the wire, galvanometer shows the zero deflection. Why it shows the zero deflection? See, consider two batteries. It is a galvanometer. Okay, now, for example, it is 10 volts. This one is 12 volts. It send the current this direction. Now, 12 volt send the current in this direction. One is clockwise, another one is anti-clockwise. Okay, so that means majority one here, which one? Majority one here, 12 volts. That's why it is dominating. Due to this influence, galvanometer shows the deflection in one side. Are you understood? Now here, it is 10 volts. This one is 12 volts. Here 12 volt is more. That's why it is influence the circuit. Due to this 12 volts, galvanometer shows the current in one direction. For example, it's potential is 10 volts. This is 10 volts. This one is also 10 volts. Okay. Now, here it's sending current. Both are in opposite direction. Totally cancelled. That means current is equal to zero. In the sense, galvanometer shows the zero deflection. In same manner, it's sending current. Both are equal, okay, and opposite direction. That's why current is equal to zero. Okay, that's why it shows the zero deflection. That means in this length, dropping potential is nothing but this battery EMF. Understood? This battery EMF without drawing any current. Here, this arrangement not draws the current. See, example of this one. Similar manner, it is sending the current. Both are cancelled. That means, without drawing the current, it shows the
potential of this cell or EMF of this cell. Okay, are you understood? Okay, at this length. So it shows the zero deflection means in this portion, dropping potential is nothing but this battery EMF. Okay, understood? Okay, now here. In this potential drop, V is equal to I, resistance of this wire in length L. Okay, that is R dash. Okay, so R dash is right as R by L into L. How it is? See, for L length, resistance is R. For small L length, what about resistance? So, you write as, you are taking this one is R dash. R dash is write as R into small L by L. You know, R by L is nothing but resistance per unit length. Simply write as rho into L. Okay. R dash is equal to what at one? Rho into L. Okay, V is equal to I rho into L. Okay, V is equal to I rho into L. You know already, I means R plus R series plus internal resistance rho into L. V is equal to E by R plus R series plus R rho in the sense R by L. It is L means balancing length. Okay. It gives the EMF of the cell. In this length, if in case you want potential gradient, okay, length is taken this side. V by L is equal to E by R plus R series plus R, R by L. Here, V by L is nothing but what at one? Potential gradient. Potential gradient. Understood? V by L is nothing but here. Potential gradient. Potential gradient is equal to here. E means primary circuit, that is standard EMF. R means resistance of the potentiometer wire. Series resistance, small r, internal resistance of primary battery. R by L, resistance per unit length of the potentiometer wire. V by L is nothing but potential gradient. Understood? Okay, this is the theory. This formula is most important. Okay, see one problem. A cell of EMF 2 volt and internal resistance 1.5 ohm is connected to the ends of 1 meter long wire. The resistance of wire is 0.5 ohm per meter. Find the value of potential gradient. Okay. Now here, given data, E is equal to what at one here? 2 volts. Okay. Internal resistance is equal to 1.5 ohm. Now here, resistance of the wire. Okay. Given 0.5 ohm per meter. Given length is 1 meter. So simply 1 meter. That means resistance of the wire is 0.5 ohm. Series resistance is not given means you are taking it as a zero. Okay, it is taken as a zero. What is the required quantity? Potential gradient V by L. It will write as R plus R series plus small r R by L. Okay, now length is given 1 meter. Now here, battery EMF is 2 by R, resistance of the wire 0.5, series resistance 0, internal resistance 1.5 into R by L. 0.5 by L means 1 meter. Okay. Now here, 2 by 0.5 plus 1.5, 2 into 0.5, 2 by 2 cancel.
So 0.5 volt per meter. This is the potential gradient. This one is potential gradient. In the next class, I will explain what are the uses of potentiometer, how to compare the EMF. So how to find out the internal resistance of the cell. Okay, in next class.